Well, good evening and welcome to Shine a Light. We're live on Facebook. This is your Bishop, Bishop Desmond. Just wanting to say a wonderful good evening to you. We're a little bit late, but these things do happen. And tonight, I just need to really focus upon how important it is for us to unify right now. At a time when there's so many different things going on that impact upon us. And it seems as though there are times, especially when we're looking for justice, equality and justice, one of the things that we're doing is we're settling for second best, and we can't allow that to happen anymore. Come on, folks, this is the future of our children here. And God reminds us of this in Genesis. The first book of the Bible reminds us that we're all equal, but we always settle for little things that are thrown at us. And we seem to make that the priority over everything else. And we must now not allow that to happen. Today in church, we focus on Jeremiah 29. And if you read that, that's Jeremiah's letter to the captives. And one of the things it reminded them of, after 70 years, God will return and free them. And the thing is, and he will expose those who deceive. And Windrush 70th, which was 2018, the Windrush scandal broke. And we were given Windrush Day. And whilst everyone's celebrating and a monument is being put up, the facts are a lot of things still have not been addressed. A lot of issues have not been dealt with. The discrimination that we face is still ongoing today. A 14-year-old boy searched because he fits a description, but it was the wrong lad. Handcuffed, thrown to the floor in stop and search. Someone rang me today and said, you were on what happened down at Aston Lane by Tesco's, because they saw him in a video watching 25 police officers turning up for one man. A man who says the police interaction started when he tried to report the fact that he had suffered a hate crime. Someone had called him a black bee, and he ended up being arrested. And it was a quite distressing scene, to be honest. I didn't see all of it, but what I saw was alarming when I saw 25 police officers. I counted them. And then a female police officer decided, when I tried to say something to her about what I've heard has happened, and that she should make a note of it, she was rather dismissive. Community relations is key, people, but our unity is our strength, and we need to stand together. We must no longer settle for second best. This Windrush monument, which has been unveiled, I'm going to be positive about it. I see it as a beginning. A lot of promises have been made. It's time to hold people to account. And I'm going to tell you this now, when you're friends with people, right, that's when liberties are taken. You know that. Look how many friendships have been broken down because of liberties which are taken. How good and wonderful it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. That's what we should right now be working towards, our unifying strength. Under oppression, we as a people made a lot of money for those who oppressed us. But on the so-called freedom, we're as divided as we can be, to the degree where our children are killing each other. And we must reinstill that all-important spirit of the Windrush generation. This week, my eyes have been opened. And it's time that we all open our eyes. But we must open our eyes to hear the hills from whence thou comest. And when we start remembering who we are, remembering where we're coming from, remembering the journey to where we are today, remembering the difficulties that we all encounter, we may well then seek a way forward. We have a prime minister who forgets who he is, or maybe he remembers who he is. You will say, your bishop sounds confusing. Well, do you know something? His actions are highly confusing as well. Forgetting that you are there to serve and not be served. Forgetting that you are the person that is supposed to ensure that justice prevails. Instead of that, you commit injustice. The one that says, we are here to receive those who are help, who need help rather. But then you want to put them on a plane to Rwanda. It's time to get real. It's time to get real. Not going to the political issues about lost elections, etc. Because the facts are, at the end of the day, the people will speak. But what we want right now is good, strong leadership. At a time where cost of living is getting out of hand. At a time when the price of goods are trying to be suppressed, but they cut the size of them. I had to buy a packet of Rich Tea biscuits the other day. And when I bought them, the diameter of the biscuits are much smaller than what they used to be. And they're more money. Are we really looking at what's going on around us? If we don't mind sharp, we might be going back to the days of power cuts. Many people said we may be going into like the winter of discontent, which was back in the late 70s, which ultimately brought down the then Prime Minister, James Callaghan. The point that I am making, folks, is this. Where's the responsibility? Our life is not a game. Our life is a serious thing. The future of our children and the future of generations to come is a serious issue. Many will say that we are in end times. Well, folks, looks like it, because do you know something? There is always confusion. There's confusion everywhere. And it's time now for us to wake up and deal with that confusion. But one thing I will say to you is this. Those who are there helping you, they're not the ones to be cursing. The ones who stand up for justice are not the ones to be cursing. Because by doing that, what you're doing is you're leaving a back door open for those who seek to oppress. So tonight, let us remember how good and wonderful it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. We remember those who have lost a lot of loved ones, a lot of people are going and leaving this earth. And moving on to be with the Lord. Let us not lose sight of who we are. But let us give thanks for those who have passed. Let us give thanks for the memories that they have left behind. And let us just focus upon doing what is right. And let me share this with you. This week, I gave serious consideration to hanging up my boots. But God says the work has not finished and we must carry on. So God bless you this evening. Heavenly Father, thank you for this time of shining a light. Father God, every Sunday night we do this. Because we do this because we worship and adore your name. And Father God, we just want to keep sending that message of unity, that message of important message of equality. The important message, Father God, that we give you thanks for helping us to rise up another day to make a difference. Father God, as we pray for those who have lost loved ones, those who are sick, Father God, we pray for them right now. Father God, those who are lost, we pray that they may be found. Father God, those in the positions of authority, we pray so much, Father God. But it seems as though they are in the clasped in the hands of the enemy. And just will not do what is right. And when they do wrong, Father God, they try to justify the wrongdoing. Father, the strength at times we have to use in firefighting behind our backs sometimes devours us, Father God. But we ask that you strengthen us now, we pray. Guide and protect your people, we pray. Father, just keep blessing us. We give you thanks for what you have done for us and brought us this far. Father, as we exit Windrush Day and the week where the Empire Windrush was celebrated, Father God, let us not just celebrate. Let us embrace what is going on around us. Let us embrace each other like the sisters and brothers that you made us to be. And Father, don't let the plans of the enemy and those who seek to oppress and think that they are better than their neighbor, don't let them win, Father. We know that your people are conquerors. And Father God, we will stand for what is right. So as we stand tonight shining this light, let this be a light of understanding. Let this be a light of deliverance. Let this be a light of freedom. But Father, let this be a light of unity that brings us together. Your scripture promises after 70 years you will return and free us from the bonds of captivity. And Father God, we know as we move on, we know the next 12 months, Father, there are going to be changes, and we pray for these important changes now. Father, we thank you for this evening. We thank you for being with us as we shine a light. But Father God, bless us, your people, we pray, as we give you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. So until next week, 8:30, 7 o'clock Panelcroft Village on Wednesday, 11 o'clock Panelcroft Village for our Sunday service, and 8:30 next Sunday night when we shine a light. God bless you. Have a wonderful week in the Lord.